Hey, my name is Maria, and when I was younger, someone told me that if I swallow a watermelon seed, then a watermelon would grow on the inside of me. Now, I don't know about you, but I don't think my tummy is big enough to grow a watermelon. We are almost done learning about the fruit of the spirit. Now, we're not talking about something like the watermelon, but you can think of it that way. There are 9 seeds of the fruit of the spirit on the inside of us. And the more we learn about them by reading the Bible and acting them out, they continue to grow on the inside of us. Don't worry, your tummy can handle it. The Bible tells us in John 14:6 that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. That means that whenever you need help, Jesus is always with you to help you. Now, let's see what my friend has to say, and I'll see you after the Bible story. Bye!
What's up, everyone? Let's praise God together, then dive into a true story from the Bible about being gentle.
Jesus is helping me. I can do the things that He does. I can love like Jesus. I believe His light can shine through me. I can do the things that He does. I can love like Jesus.
Just follow me through.
Who?
Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through. Who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Well, hello there. I'm Aisha. Welcome to my cupcake food truck. Do you want to see my latest creation? Ta-da! These are my fancy feather cupcakes. I made them for my friend's party. Look at those feathers. Have you ever touched a feather? They are so soft and light and gentle, which is what today's story is about. If you're ready for a story, on the count of three, yell, "Tell me a story." 1, 2, 3, tell me a story. Today's true story from the Bible begins with Jesus teaching a group of people. It was very exciting. Everyone wanted to talk to him. "Talk to me, Jesus!
Talk to me!
Talk to me!" the crowd said. Many parents brought their children to see Jesus. They wanted their children to be so close that Jesus could touch them. But when the little children went up to Jesus, Jesus' friends, the disciples, told the children to go away. The disciples were not being gentle. Do you know what the word gentle means? It's like when you're playing with a friend and they take your toy away. You can kindly ask for it back and not yell or use mean words. That's being gentle. In the story, were Jesus' friends being gentle? No, but Jesus was gentle. He said, "Wait, let the little children come to me." Jesus let them come right up to the front. He hugged them and was kind and talked to them. Was Jesus being gentle? Yes! And Jesus wants to help us be gentle too. Like when you're with a new baby, we need to be gentle with our hands and feet when we are around them. Or when your friends are playing with a puzzle but you want to play something else. Instead of shouting your angry words, you can use gentle words and ask them to play something else. You use gentle hands so you don't hurt the baby, and you use gentle words so you don't hurt your friend's feelings. Jesus can help us choose to be gentle. Jesus can help us do everything. Did you like the story? If you did, give it 2 thumbs up. 2 thumbs up. Hey there, Ollie. Tell me, who can help you do everything?
Jesus can help me do everything. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who can help you do everything?
Jesus can help me do everything. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Bye.
Jesus can help us choose love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. All we have to do is ask Him to help us. Before we go, let's pray. Or simply put, let's talk to God. When we talk to God, He listens. Then I'll give you and your family some next steps. Let's bow our heads and close our eyes. Dear God, thank you for being the way, the truth, and the life. We thank you for helping us fulfill the 9 C's of the Spirit. In your name we pray, amen. It was great talking to you today. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Summer is here, and we've got a hot topic to share with you. As promised, we want you to check out this week's family activity guide that you can download from our Facebook parent group, website, or follow it right from your phone. Inside the packet, you will find amazing activities that make it easy to keep growing in God's Word with your preschooler. It tells you what to say, guides you through a simple and fun activity, guides you through a time of prayer, and y'all, there's so much more in there. Decide when and how you want to use these great tools that are right at your fingertips, and you will be just simply amazed at how much your preschooler is learning and growing in their faith right at home with you. Did you enjoy this amazing on-demand service? If so, did you know that we also have returned to in-person services for kids? If you or your child are interested in in-person services, please feel free to join us on either our Birmingham, Alabama or Columbus, Georgia campus. For more details about the in-person service on the campus that you would like to attend, special days when we worship together in the main sanctuary as a family, and more, please visit faithchapel.net/family. We are honored to assist you and your child grow their relationship with God. Have a fantastic day. Bye.